You'll be happy. I'm about to pick up on one of your points to ask the vice president, which is he points out that you would like to add a public option to Obamacare. And
yes.
The argument that he makes and other Republicans make is that that is going to end private insurance.
It is
and
not.
Well, if I'm I sorry. Can ask you the question, it will
not
end
what your party says, by the way.
It will end private insurance and create a government takeover of health care.
It does not. It's only for those people who are so poor they qualify for Medicaid. They can get that free in most states, except governors who want to deny people who are poor Medicaid. Anyone who qualifies for Medicare would, Medicaid would automatically be enrolled in the public option. The vast majority of the American people would still not be in that option, number one.
Joe, you agreed with Bernie Sanders, left, on the manifesto,
manifesto.
And that gives you socialized medicine.
Look, hey, I'm not going to listen to him. The fact of the matter is, I beat Bernie Sanders.
Not by much.
I beat him a whole hell of a lot. I'm here standing facing
Pocahontas
you all, buddy.
Pocahontas would have left 2 days early. You would have lost every primary.
All he knows how to do is
Super Tuesday. You got very lucky.
Here's the deal. I got very lucky. I'm going to get very lucky tonight as well. And tonight I'm going
with
to
what?
Make sure because here's the deal. Here's the deal. The fact is that everything he's saying so far is simply a lie. I'm not here to call out his lies. Everybody knows he's a liar.
But you
I just
agree.
Want to make
Joe,
sure.
Joe, you're the liar.
I want to make sure.
You graduated last in your class, not first in your class.
I want to make
Mr.
sure.
Mr. President, can you let him finish, sir?
No, he doesn't know how to do that. He has,
you'd
you know,
surprised.
You pick
be surprised.
The
ahead,
wrong
Joe.
Guy, the wrong night at the wrong time.
Listen, you agreed with
Here's
Bernie
the
Sanders. So the
whole idea,
let him,
there is no manifesto, number
Please
one.
Please let him speak, Mr. President.
Number two.
You just lost the left.
Number two.
You just lost the left. You agreed with Bernie Sanders on a plan.
How, folks,
absolutely
folks,
agreed
do you have
to,
any idea what this clown's doing?
They call it
Mr.
Medicare.
You have
President.
Any do?
Socialized medicine.
Mr. President.
Well, I tell you what, he is not for any help for people needing health care. Because
Who is it?
His,
Bernie?
Because he, in fact, already has cost 10 million people their health care that they had from their employers because of his recession. Number one. Number two, there are 20 million people getting health care through Obamacare now that he wants to take it away. He won't ever look you in the eye and say that's what he wants to do. Take it away.
No, I want to give
Number
him better health care at a much lower price because
Obamacare
is no good.
By the way, he doesn't know how
I've
to do that.
I've already fixed it.
He has never
I've
offered a plan.
Fixed it to an extent.
He has
Obamacare,
never done a single
as you might
thing.
Know, but probably don't. Obamacare
gentlemen, you realize
no
if you're
good.
Both Joe. Speaking at the
it's
same
no
time.
And it's too expensive.
Let the president's go ahead, sir.
Obamacare is no good. We made it better. And I had a choice to make very early on. We took away the individual mandate. We guarantee pre-existing conditions, but took away the individual mandate. Listen, this is the way it is. And that destroyed that. They shouldn't even call it Obamacare. Then I had a choice to make. Do I let my people run it really well or badly? Yeah. If I run it badly, they'll probably blame him, but they'll blame me. But more importantly, I want to help people. OK, I said, you got to run it so well.
That's what
and I just
for.
Had a meeting with them. They said the problem is no matter how well you run Obamacare, it's a disaster. It's too expensive.
Okay.
Premiums
you,
are too high,
That's
and it doesn't work.
That's
so we do
no,
want to
no,
get
no.
rid of it. Chris, we want to get rid of it.
I understand
and get
it, sir, but I have to
and,
give you roughly equal time.
Good.
Please let the vice president talk.
Good.
He has no plan for health care.
Of course
he
we do.
Sends,
please.
He sends out wishful thinking. He has executive orders that have no power. He hasn't lowered drug costs for anybody. He's been promising a health care plan since he got elected. He has none, like almost everything else he talks about. He does not have a plan. He doesn't have a plan. And the fact is, this man doesn't know what he's talking about.
All right.
He's
I have one final question for you,
sure.
Mr. Vice President. If Senate Republicans, we were talking originally about the Supreme Court here, if Senate Republicans go ahead and confirm Justice Barrett, there has been talk about ending the filibuster or even packing the court, adding to the 9 justices there. You call this a distraction by the president, but in fact, it wasn't brought up by the president. It was brought up by some of your Democratic colleagues in the Congress. So my question to you is, you have refused in the past to talk about it. Are you willing to tell the American people tonight whether or not you will support either ending the filibuster or packing the court?
Whatever position I take in that, that'll become the issue. The issue is the American people should speak. You should go out and vote. You're in voting now. Vote and let your senators know how strongly you feel. Vote now.
Are you going to pack the
Make
court?
Sure you, in fact, let people know you're a senator. I'm not going to answer the question.
Why
because,
would you answer that
because
question?
Because the question is,
radical left.
Will you shut
up,
man?
Listen, who is on your list, Joe?
This
Who's
is
on your
so
list?
Right.
Gentlemen,
this is,
I think
this
we've
is
ended
so
this.
Unprecedented.
He's going to pack the court. We have
not
going to give a list.
We have ended this segment. We're going to move on to the second segment.
That was really a productive segment, wasn't it? Keep yapping, man.
The people understand, Joe.
They should.
47 years, you've done nothing. They understand.
Oh. All right.